Spring 2018. Normally, I'm an associate professor of philosophy at the University of Kansas. Generally, in my research, I'm interested in establishing the promises and challenges of connecting different sciences to each other. In particular, I focus on evolutionary biology and the cognitive and social sciences. Now, in my past work, I mostly focused on connections between evolutionary biology and cognitive sciences. So my recent book, Efficient Cognition, has just come out, and in the book I look at some of the evolutionary pressures that have shaped the evolution of a representational way of interacting with the environment. So some organisms switch away from relying just on perceptually mediated reflexes to interact with the environment, and they rely on something more complex, higher-order mental states with content to interact with the environment. What I want to do here in the center, though, is to focus more on the connections between evolutionary biology and the social sciences, in particular the connections between evolutionary biology and economics. In that context, there are two questions that I'm looking to investigate further. The first question, not unrelated to my previous work on the evolution of representational decision-making, concerns what we can learn about human economic decision-making by looking at data on animal economic decision-making. That's become popular in the last 10 years or so, but I think there, in order to really make progress in that field, there are a few other questions we need to get clear on first. And the first of these questions actually is just what the dispute in economics is all about. So when we try to study human economic decision making, there's a lot of controversy, a lot of discussion, but exactly what are people discussing? It turns out that getting clear on that is not straightforward, but very important. Once one does get clear on that, the second problem arises, namely how can we interpret the data from animals so as to make them relevant to that discussion in economics. And so what I'm trying to do here at the center, the first project what I'm trying to do here is to come up with a framework for relating, for interpreting and relating the data on animal economic decision making, and bring that data then to bear on questions in economics. The second project that I'd like to complete while here at the center is concerns a particular modeling technique that's sort of widely known to be sort of very much part of the economic toolkit, namely equilibrium modeling. So it's sort of known that economists, when they study economic systems, they employ models and that sort of center on stable equilibrium states. It's also often thought that this is problematic in one way or another, because you think that real economic systems are complex systems that might not have any sort of stable equilibrium state. So what use is there in relying on equilibrium models in understanding economic systems that might not have these kinds of states? What I try to do here is to, again, first just get clear on exactly what the worry is with equilibrium modeling in economics. Once that's become clearer, I want to look at the discussion in evolutionary ecology to see what lessons that holds for discussion in economics. In evolutionary ecology, it turns out equilibrium modeling is also quite widespread, but also has seen discussion and controversy. What I'm trying to do is to see if there's anything in that discussion in ecology that is applicable to the discussion in economics as well, so that we can make progress in the latter by looking at the discussion in biology and just also figuring out how that connection can be established. I'm very excited to be here, and I'm looking forward to discussing these issues with the other people at the center.